writes these words in the book of Romans, the 8th chapter and the 18th verse. It reads as follows, "For I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared to the glory which shall be revealed in us." The Apostle Paul was writing this to a church that was being besieged at that time, a church that was under duress from so many things at that particular time. But in the midst of all of these things that he's writing to this church, he's even has some words there to even inspire those of us who live in the 21st century. The Apostle Paul was painting the picture to this church that your current situation will never be as good to what God has in store for you down the line. He's letting them know that better days are ahead. And that's what I submit to you, child of God, that God has better days for you. We're living in a day now with so many challenges. We have violence at every turn. We have the seemingly coldness of man. People are doing heinous crimes. Money is tight. The economy is rocking. Their racial tension is as thick. It can be cut literally with a knife. And gas prices are just extraordinary. But in the midst of all of these things, Paul was writing to us that I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared to the glory which shall be revealed. Paul's letting us know that there is a better day coming. There is a brighter day coming. I was thinking about what Paul wrote in Romans 8:28. He said, "For now we know that all things work together for the good of them who love God, for them who are the called according to his purpose." Let me tell you, child of God, that no matter what you're going through, that thing that you're going through is pushing you closer to where God would have you to be. Yeah, you may be looming and dealing with a financial dilemma, a dilemma in your body, a dilemma in your family, but God is moving you to a brighter day. This is just a bump in the road on your road to destiny. Yeah, God has so much in store for you. We serve a God that has the cattle on 1,000 hills. We serve a God that said the silver is mine and the gold is mine. We serve a God whose name is Jehovah Rapha, the Lord, our healer. There's no condition in your body. There's nothing that you are dealing with that God can't solve. We also serve a God that said in Psalm, that he told the psalmist that I am the judge. I set it down one and I raise it up another. In Psalm 75, he said that promotion doesn't come from the north, the south, the east, and the west. He said, but God is the judge. Saints, we don't have to look to men for our elevation. God has your day in store. God has your moment in store. God is going to take you to where you need to be. Just trust God. Better days are ahead. And in the words of the Bishop Charles Edward Blake, I say, as he would say and so often, I see you in the future, and you look much better than you look right now.